from her lips to God's ears.
You did this. You murdered the vice president.
I prefer to see it as liberation. The freedom to usher in new perspectives of leadership.
You are insane.
Again, I believe we'll have to agree to disagree.
Why did you let me in on it? You knew that I would see the truth.
I thought I made that clear in our last conversation.
Third ruler in the kingdom.
Technically, you'd be number two, but everything's negotiable.
Those people that you killed, they were your soldiers. Did you offer them the opportunity to negotiate their own lives?
Their mission was to serve the greater good of the unit. In that respect, they died heroes. We should all be thankful to pass with such dignity.
Dignity? Is that what it took? To murder Miranda Ellis on her wedding day? Or was she just more collateral damage on the way to the White House?
We have philosophical differences. I respect that. But at the core, we both desire the same things. A safe and powerful land in which to raise our children, build our future. You've seen what we can accomplish without you. Imagine the things we could do together.
Are you suggesting this was all some sort of audition for my benefit?
Not an audition. A preview. The opening act of the greatest drama ever written by a man. An epic tale. Born of victory. Penned in blood. You need only to decide on which side of the curtain you'll stand.
And if I turn away?
You won't need psychic powers to see that future. There won't be one. Think it over, John. It's almost showtime.
Do you see yourself in the white spotlight? Then play the game too. you know, psychic head games, that's fine, okay? Let's see what my third eye tells me about the famous Johnny Smith. I see a man that has more cameras in his living room than the Bellagio has in its high roller's pit. A man so paranoid that people will get into his little hermetic world that he spies on himself. I see a man who lives in a 10,000 square foot mansion whose only personal decorating touch is a 42 inch plasma television. I see a lonely screwed up guy who thinks he's some kind of savior, butting into everybody's business because it keeps him too busy to look into the mirror.